Hello everyone, this is Sudipto from Technical Potpourri and welcome to another video. In today's video, I will be showing you how you can dynamically pass bind variables to a SQL query. So without any further delay, let's explore this with some examples. So here I am in my developer console. I'm going to write few code to show you how you can use that feature. To start with, let me create a map. And this map will be of type string and object. Let's give a name as account binds and let's create this map string and object. And let's give a name here, which is account name. And for account name, let's give an account name which I know is present in my org. So I've created the map. Now let's use that map in the query and show you how you can use that. To do that, let me create a list of accounts which I'll be fetching using SQL query. So for that, database.queryWithBinds. Instead of doing normal query, we'll be using query with binds. And I'll explain what is query with binds and what extra feature it will give you. So start with, we'll write the query first. The query is select ID from account where name equals to. And this time I'll give a bind variable, which is this one. That's my query. The bind variable information will come from the map. The name of the map is this. And in the access level, I will be putting access level dot user mode. And then let's do a system.debug and find out the number of accounts received, which is accounts dot size. Let's save that and execute this. Here is a log and I can see the number of account fetched is 1. So let's understand what I'm doing here. So as you can see here, I'm first creating a map. This is a very basic map I'm creating here. Instead of the query, database.query, I'm using a new function which is called query with binds. And the first parameter is basically SQL statement where select ID from account where name equals to account name. But the beauty here is that the bind variable is getting resolved from a map directly. And the name of the map I'm giving here, which is account binds. Another thing to notice is that I've used a parameter access level in the query. This is something new that became GA in Spring 23 release. I have a dedicated blog and a video explaining the concept. You will find the link at the top right corner or in the description of this video. Highly recommended that you take advantage of this new feature. But again, coming to this point, all I'm doing, creating a query, using the bind variable, but the bind variable is getting resolved directly from the map, which is where the name of the map is account binds. So now, as you can see here, I've created a map, but the map basically contains only one value. Now, if the map contains one value, that doesn't make much sense unless map contains multiple values, right? So in my next example, what I'll show you how to create a map containing multiple accounts name. And then use that map to dynamically pass bind variables to the query. So let's write the code. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to modify this portion of the code. Here, instead of this one, I'll just initiate the map first. That's the map. Now I'll be putting more values to the map. So to do that, this dot put in the put, I will be giving this name and here I'll be putting all the name of the accounts that I want to fetch. So for example, this is my first account name. My second account name is, let's say, this one. My third account name is and these are all the accounts which are already present in my org. So now I'll be executing the same query again. Account name, it's coming from the map account binds and this. So let's save that and execute the same query again. Open the log and this time, as you can see, number of account fetched is 3. So what I'm doing here compared to the previous one, in the previous one, my map contains only one value against the key account name. But this time what I'm doing, I'm putting multiple values against the key account name. And then when I'm using that account name key and the map, the SQL query will be able to get all the values from the map with the key this and resolve that in the bind variable. But to use that, you need to use the query with binds method, not the normal query method. I think this feature is really powerful. It will help you to write optimized code. Let me know what you think, how you are using this in your project. Put your feedback in the comment section of this video. And with that, I hope this video is helpful. Please hit the like icon and share. And please subscribe to my channel to get update about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you.